Hello and welcome to Ask Excite. I'm Tim Bushnell with Expert Cytometry. And today's question comes from Glenda, who asks, how do you clear a clog? Now that's a great question because many people get faced with clogs at some point in their flow cytometry career, and knowing how to get rid of them is an important step, especially if it's late at night and you don't want to wait till somebody else can come fix it. Now clogs can happen, let me start by saying here's a flow cell. A clog can happen down here at the sample side or on this side, on the waist side. They typically manifest themselves in different ways. If you have a clog down here, you typically lose sample. You don't see cells. A clog up here typically will manifest itself by showing a issue in, if you look at a time plot versus the different lasers, because it will generally impact the laser delay. You tend to see a signal fall off on one of the lasers far away from the trigger laser. So let's say for a minute you have a clog here. First step, make sure you have a clog. Put some beads on and see if you can get the beads through. That's going to help you identify how bad the clog is. Second thing, take your tube off, and I use the prime feature. I will prime 3 times, leaving nothing on the here. I don't want if whatever shoots in out of here after I prime to necessarily get in a tube. After that, put my beads back on. If I don't see anything, we go to step two. Step two is to take something like this, a stylus, and insert it into this sample and into this sip here and clean it up by moving this up and down, pulling it out. Be careful to hold on to it so we don't lose it in the flow cell. Again, beads go back on, no beads. Now we're starting to get to a serious clog. So in that case, on this instrument here, there's a ring. This is where the sip is, and we have a nut that secures this. Remove the nut and pull this out. This is now that whole assembly. This is the part that's going into the flow cell. This is where you're putting your sample. Take this apart. I'm taking off. This is the provides stability on this side. And now you can either take a syringe and try to blow a liquid through here, use air. Some people's suggestion was even to sonicate this to try to clean it out. If you're at that point, you really want to focus on getting this nice and clean. When you're done, you reassemble it. The beauty of this system is that, one, it has a notch, so you put it in the right orientation at the same time. And two, because of that and because of the way it's set up, it can't go any further into the flow cell than it's supposed to. So there, put it on, check to see if you have flow. If you do, great. If not, you may have some really significant issues, and this is the time when you really want to call somebody in. In fact, for the most part, if you're going to try to take this apart, unless you've done it before, you probably want to call somebody from the core staff in to help you. Remember, if you have any more questions, go to getflowtraining.com to get some more information. If you have questions, you can send them here to me at askexcite@expertcytometry.com. Thanks for another Ask Excite. Until next time, be sure to keep tuned for the best practices for flow cytometry right here with Tim, me, and Team Excite.